Water scarcity. In our previous sessions on hydrosphere, we had seen the exact distribution of water on our planet, the various uses of it, and how water is replenished in a continuous manner through water cycle. So by now, we know how much essential water is to human life and also to other living organisms on Earth. Of the total water available on the Earth, the water which is present in rivers, lakes, ponds, as well as the underground water is what actually are available for our various uses. So these freshwater sources can be rightly called the lifeblood of our planet. And we all know only 3% of the total water available on the Earth is fresh water. Water is not just important for the biotic components, but it is equally valued from the ecosystem and environmental point of view. But friends, this essential natural resource is under a threat, as the water usage has been growing at more than twice the rate of population increase. And moreover, the water distribution throughout the globe is uneven, which simply means that water is in abundance at some places, whereas it is scarce at some other. Regions like Australia, Africa, Middle East has a very little natural freshwater resource, and so also they face problems of water shortage. The continent of Australia, being dry, faces frequent incidents of drought. In certain regions of Africa, more than a quarter of the population spends more than an hour per round trip to collect water. The Arab countries again face problems of water scarcity. And also, these regions have a threat to desertification and land degradation. And friends, one thing we must remember here is, whenever we talk about water scarcity, it is always associated with the freshwater resources. So let's all try to understand this problem of water scarcity and some of the causes of it a little better. Water scarcity, in simple terms, could be said as either lack of enough water or lack of access to clean water. Water can be made clean only if it's available. We can relate water scarcity as an imbalance between supply and demand that varies according to local conditions. Water scarcity could be of two different types. First is the physical water scarcity. It is exactly how it sounds like. There is a limited physical access to water resource when the demand outstrips the land's ability to provide the needed water, you have physical scarcity. Friends, here I give you three situations, and you need to identify whether there is water scarcity or not. Now suppose there is a desert region where the water availability is low, as well as the actual usage is low. So can we call this area to be water scarce? No, because we said water scarcity to be the imbalance in demand and supply. In this case, the availability, that is the supply, is less, but the demand or the use is also less. However, if there is a place where the natural water availability is abundant, but the area has excessive population growth, problems of pollution and unsustainable consumption, then can we call that place to be water scarce? Yes, we call this place to be water scarce. Even though this place has water supply, there is a growing demand of it, causing an imbalance between the two. Now suppose, if there is a place where there is sufficient groundwater resource, but due to very high cost of extracting this resource, people are not able to use it. Then can we call that place to be water scarce? Yes, we call this region to be water scarce. But here, it's not a case of physical scarcity. This is because there is water available in this region, but because of economic constraints, that is lack of financial aid or due to less infrastructural facilities, people are not able to access this available water. So, the second type of water scarcity is economic water scarcity. It exists when there is an adequate source of water in an area, but there are no proper means to utilize it in terms of money or technological know-how. But friends, how do we identify whether a country is water scarce or not? Well, there are certain indicators that reflects whether a country is water scarce or not. When the water supplies drop below 1,000 cubic meters per person per year, country faces water scarcity. But when these water supply drops below 500 cubic meters per person per year, the country faces absolute scarcity. Well, I hope the concept of water scarcity is clear now. In our previous session, we had all seen how the various water resources are distributed in India, and the country is blessed with almost all types of water resources. But why do we still hear cases of water shortage or scarcity in India? Well, with a large diverse population, India ranks second in the world in terms of its population density. And this growing population has resulted in a growing demand for water. And we humans are a lot more careless. We waste more water than what we actually need. Thus, population explosion is one of the reasons for water scarcity. This growing population also tends to shift from rural to urban areas, resulting in a gradual increase in the urban population. And urbanization further increases the water requirement for construction and for other developmental activities. This rapidly growing population has also resulted in an increasing number of industries. Water is required at almost every stage of production. This puts a heavy load on the total fresh water available. And nearly 60% of the Indian population depends on agriculture for their livelihood and uses nearly 90% of all water for irrigation. Farmers have exploited the groundwater resources by uncontrolled use of borewell technology, as there is no proper irrigation facilities available in the country. In order to meet the basic needs of food, clothing and shelter for the growing population, many of the forested areas are cut down, leading to deforestation. When part of a forest is removed, the trees no longer transpire water, resulting in a much drier climate. Deforestation reduces the content of water in soil and groundwater. Pollution of water resources is another major concern which is affecting the water supply as well as human health. Many water resources of the country are polluted or contaminated by chemicals as well as biological pollutants. This is due to the discharge of untreated sewage from homes, toxic chemicals from industries, pesticides and insecticides used in agriculture into the nearby water bodies. These were some of the reasons that is affecting the water quality as well as quantity, and making it a scarce resource. But friends, how do we tackle this problem? Is there a solution to it? To find the answer to these questions, please tune into our coming session. Till then, you may suggest some of the measures we can take to address this problem through your comments. I hope you have liked this session. For more such interesting videos on environment, do subscribe to our channel. So, till we meet the next time, keep watching, keep learning, and do save water.